I can't call it, man. Just good to hear from you, man. Everything going? Everything good?
Yeah, man. Talk about shit.
Talk about shit, man. My boule, man.
Okay, you got that. Okay, I'm fucking with you. What's up, though?
All right, so yo, Zoe, man, look, do me a favor, man. Introduce yourself to the people, man, and give the people a little bit of history about where you're from.
Ali Zoe Adam, man. I'm from Rolling Oak, Kansas City, 187th Street. Man, I just love Miami, you know?
Tell us about when you first came from Haiti to Miami.
When I came from Haiti and Miami, I went to Crestview Elementary. That motherfucker was rocking, but when I went to that middle school, 85, 86, that's when it turned up Parkway Middle School, man. Parkway Middle School was live. It was the most dangerous middle school, man, you know what I'm saying? 85, 86 in Miami, you know? Little clique that had a little strong arm named the Ewing Boys, you know? They about 100, 150 deep. So.
Life in the penitentiary, all them boys deported. Shout out to them. We got niggas that's in jail in Haiti. They ain't got nowhere to shit in prison.
Stop.
You know what I'm saying? They eat
Fritz.
They only eat grits
so pop,
every day.
Real nice.
You can't check three meals, you know what I'm saying?
Three boys up.
Two different niggas that's doing the time different ways, you know what I'm saying? It's niggas, man, sleeping with fucking flies and motherfucking, what's them shit called, Mangue?
Mosquitoes.
Mosquitoes.
Oh, all night.
Shout out to tout Haitien, yo, tout côté.
Yeah, deportees, yo. Haiti, Bahamas, everywhere.
Let's keep the Haitien son, man,
you know what I'm saying?
One time for partner, Jimmy Hinchman, you look at Pune.
Tout temps, y'all niggas better holler. You make you motherfucking major ender.
Born and raised in the county of Dade.
I am a group. Damn, I be gone till November. But fuck it, I ain't trippin', I know Drizzy gon' kill him. I'm sticking to the script like lint on denim. Mama said if the rules ain't bent, don't bend them. Real nigga.
Hallucination of money, why nigga's stomach just rumble? Had to fuck with the Haitians and break a kilo to crumbles. Nigga living in rubble, but then I'm labeled a rebel. Any nigga won't rumble, somebody hand me a shovel. Gotta silence the lambs, get on my buffalo.
You ain't gonna believe this shit.
Vampire life.
Santana, what's up?
Skull gang. Flocka, you got the shotty? Go. Half a million y'all in the bag.
With the money machine.
If this was Philly, they would say I'm in my bag.
Meek, what up?
Quarter million with the paper tag. And I keep the 9 million playing laser tag. Condo in Miami, that's my favorite pad. Watch them Rondo versus Miami, he just made it pad. Gotta coop it when we race some pads. Body stupid with a crazy ass. High heel, red bottoms. And I miss my niggas off for real and fast. Got him. He doing 30, pray for 65%. In the car dirty, bitch, you know I'm riding bent.
Non pas peur, Vinaza, non pas peur. C'est danser, non vite danser. Belle fille, non vite caresser. S'il vous plaît, avancez.
Getting deep? Hey, you gotta make these homies have a shabby.
Talking about dumb niggas?
Yeah, probably not.
Yeah, everybody know. I'm around the way. Stay away, dude.
Look at this young buck giving me advice. Yeah, I'm good.
Park, word up.
You gotta see who they're rolling with. Madonna. She's crazy. It ain't just street shit no more, Christopher.
You ain't even listening, bro.
Ah, this that shit. This is crazy, man. Come on, lad. Hey, so I want to introduce you to my man, Jimmy Hinchman.
Jimmy Hinchman.
Yeah, come on, talk to you about Jimmy Hinchman. What are you talking about?
It was me that put all the niggas on. It was me. What were the niggas talking about?
On the morning of May 14th, 2012, in the federal courthouse in Brooklyn, New York, the assistant prosecuting attorney gave her opening statement against James Rosemond. She set out to prove that Jimmy was the leader of a multi-million dollar drug ring, that he was the sole kingpin, the mastermind of an organization that trafficked hundreds of kilos a month and employed dozens of people. She continued to describe Jimmy's lavish lifestyle to the 14-person jury, clearly painting the picture that Jimmy had a lot of money and that he lived a life of luxury. Almost as an afterthought, she mentioned Jimmy was the CEO of a music company. His music career was just a footnote in the summation of his criminal life. And why wouldn't it be? In the eyes of the prosecutors, Jimmy's music business was nothing more than a front.
It was unbelievable to these people that I was doing business the right way. In their brains, Jimmy Rosemont, the guy that we know, who knows gangsters all over the country, they could not believe that I was making millions of dollars a year, legitimately.
This call is from a federal prison.
1996. 31 years old at that point. Goof Theory's on tour. Gotta stay out in L.A. for a little while.
By all standards, it appeared Jimmy's early success with Groove Theory and Salt-N-Pepa was fortuitous at best. He was still a wanted felon who had one foot in the music industry and one foot in the streets.
It was very uncomfortable out there. I remember having a conversation with Biggie, Nas, Jay-Z, and any other East Coast rapper that I was running into.